Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel Key Art and Design for NIFT, NID and UCT. As you all know, we have started a series of different videos through which we will be guiding you step by step for the preparation of NIFT, NID academic year 2022. This video is the second part of the series Current Affairs, in which we will be discussing 10 important questions of the latest current affairs. This video is just to give you all an idea that what type of question you can get in the entrance exam of NIFT, NID. And in case you missed the first episode, link is given in the description. So let's start the video and don't forget to like and subscribe our channel as some interesting and important videos are coming soon. Question number one, Bandi Chor Divas, Day of Liberation, is associated with which religion? Option number A, Hinduism, B, Islam, C, Sikhism, D, Jainism. And the answer is Sikhism. Bandi Chor Divas, Day of Liberation, which coincides with Diwali Day, is a Sikh day of celebration. It commemorates the day Guru Har Gobind Ji was released from Mughal jail at Gwalior Fort. Mughal Emperor Jahangir had imprisoned the sixth Guru Har Gobind after killing his father Guru Arjan Devi for refusing to convert to Islam. On Diwali Day, when it was decided that Guru Har Gobind Ji would be released, he instead that the 52 kings wrongfully held like him shall walk out. Bandi means an inmate held in prison for political reasons. Question number two. Which global company has changed its name to Capricorn Energy PLC? And the options are BP Oil and Gas, Gain Energy PLC, ONGC Videsh, Reliance Energy. And the answer is Crane Energy PLC. Britain-based oil and gas explorer Crane Energy PLC has stated that it has changed its name to Capricorn Energy PLC, and the same could come into effect from December 2021. The company has been involved in a USD 1 billion retrospective tax dispute with the government of India, and the case has come to a point of closure. Question number three. As per a recent NASA study on climate change, which crop is said to see growth of 17% due to climate change? And the options are rice, wheat, maize, cotton. And the answer is wheat. According to a new NASA study published in the journal Nature Food, climate change may affect the production of maize and wheat by 2030 under a high greenhouse gas emission scenario. As per the study, maize crop yields are projected to decline by 24%, while wheat could potentially see a growth of about 17%. This is due to increase in temperature, shifts in rainfall patterns, and elevated surface CO2 concentration from greenhouse gas emissions. Question number four. Mandakini River, which was seen in the news recently, starts in which state? And your options are Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar. And the answer is Madhya Pradesh. The river Mandakini, a tributary of the Yamuna, starts in Madhya Pradesh's Satna district and flow into Yamuna in Uttar Pradesh, Chitrakoot district. The river flows through Sati Anusuya, a perennial trough where many springs feed into it. It was seen in the news recently as encroachment, concretization, and pollution are causing severe damages to the river. Which Indian state has announced full exemptions of motor vehicle taxes and registration fees on electric vehicles? Options are A, Odisha, B, Andhra Pradesh, C, Telangana, D, Punjab. And your answer is Odisha. The Odisha government announced full exemptions of motor vehicle taxes and registration fees on electric vehicles in the state. The exemptions, which was granted under the Odisha Motor Vehicle Taxation Act, is applicable till 2025. The incentives for the buyers, manufacturers, batteries, and charging station of electric vehicles were also extended under the Odisha Electric Vehicle Policy. Question number six. Which organization delivered first ship of Project 15B class destroyer, Yard 12704, विकासापट्टनम टू द इंडियन नेवी. जो ऑप्शन आर डीआरडीओ, बी मेजागॉन डॉक शिप बिल्डर, सी गार्डन रिच शिप बिल्डर, डी एचएएल. जो आंसर इज मेजागॉन डॉक शिप बिल्डर. Mezagon Dock Shipbuilders MDL has delivered first ship of project 15B class destroyer yard 12704 Vikasapatnam to the Indian Navy. The ship is constructed using indigenous steel DMR 249A and is among the largest destroyers constructed in India. It has an overall length of 164 meter and a displacement of over 7500 tons. It is armed with supersonic surface-to-surface BrahMos missiles and Barak 8 long-range surface-to-air missiles. Question number 5. What is the name of the website launched by India Climate Expert for assessing equity in climate action? And your options are Climate Equity Monitor, Option B, Bharat Climate Monitor, Option C, Bharat Climate Dashboard, Option D, Global CC Monitor. And your answer is Climate Equity Monitor. Independent researchers from India has conceptualized and developed an online dashboard named Climate Equity Monitor on global climate policy. The Climate Equity Monitor dashboard provides an online dashboard for assessing equity in climate action. Inequalities in emissions, energy consumption across the world, and the policies of several countries, it aims to monitor the performance of Annex One parties under the UNFCCC developed countries. Question number 8. After a new research conducted in the UK, which vaccine has reduced the risk of developing a cancer by 62%? And your options are A, human papillomavirus HPV vaccine, option number B, tetanus, diphtheria, pertussis, DTAP, option number C, varicella, option number D, measles, mumps, rubella, MMR. And the answer is human papillomavirus HPV vaccine. A new research funded by Cancer Research UK has recently found that human papillomavirus HPV vaccine reduced the risk of developing the cancer by 62% in women between the age of 14 and 16. Human papillomavirus HPV vaccine is administered to protect against cervical cancer in women. As per the research, it reduced the risk by 34% in women who were aged 16 to 18 years when they were offered the jab. Question number 9. Which Indian bank launched the first video life certificate service for pensioners? And your options are A, Punjab National Bank, B, Canara Bank, C, State Bank of India, D, Bank of Baroda. And the option is State Bank of India. The State Bank of India, SBI, had launched the first video life certificate service for pensioners. This new facility will allow pensioners to submit their life certificate through video from their home. As per the SBI, this facility is available for only pensioners and spouse of the pensioner. Receiving a pension will not be able to use this facility. The process of video life certificate is paperless and also available free of cost. Question number 10. Which country has announced plans to send an indigenous rover to the moon by 2026? And your options are A, Germany, B, Saudi Arabia, C, Israel, D, Australia. And the answer is Australia. The Australian Space Agency announced plans to send an Australian-made rover to the moon by 2026 under a deal with NASA. Another separate mission conducted by private companies in Australia and Canada in conjunction with the University of Technology, Sydney, may send another rover on the moon by mid-2024. The arm will collect high-resolution data and information on the physical and chemical composition of lunar dust, soil, and rock, with a goal of finding water. So thank you everyone for watching this video. We hope you liked all the questions and got some information. To keep getting important questions of current affairs, don't forget to subscribe our channel and like this video.